we're going to go ahead and get right into it with our first group, the Ladies of Cake!
Maybe I'll get to the 70s. Okay. you're taking away my 20s.
It's one sticky note for the 20s. It just says worked.
Yeah, I mean, my only expectation for my 20s was to survive. Today! It's okay. Plenty for the 30s. Okay? Yes, I'm gonna be ambitious for the 30s and the 40s too. And then maybe rest in the 50s.
Look, Cher, I know turning 29 brings upon a lot of issues. The Saturn's return, if you will.
Most of all, yes.
Look, you're gonna get through this, okay? You just gotta stop looking at things like it's a post-it note on a wall.
It's not just one, it's like tens of them, all color-coded, all of them with a goal in mind, so that I can just like go by every year and just like, huh, eat healthier. Maybe next year. Huh, change the job. Next year. And see, and I go down the list until I get one that I might have done.
You know what my family always says? Life is like a hurricane on a wall of post-it notes.
Look, the important thing you need to remember, Chad, is that life is like a hurricane on a wall of post-it notes.
Yeah.
Don't forget that.
Yeah, Mom. I know, but just for once I'd like to have an ambition, you know?
No! You can't have ambitions in a hurricane, they all get blown away! Never plan for anything! You're never nailed down to the ground that way, you're free as a bird! Go wherever the hurricane winds take you!
Look, I know, but FEMA never comes!
That's the lesson of the hurricane, Chad. You need to rely on yourself. It's a hard lesson.
So what you're saying basically is that your mommy issues make you just like trash my entire life plan?
We all got mom issues.
Yeah, mine was that my mom was so disorganized, she always gave me just like, you know, like the frozen foot thing. I just like...
Here's a present to
the thing. Mom, it's ravioli again. This is the fifth time this week.
Oh, I didn't notice. Do you want another frozen food thing? I can find something. Here, just okay. Just please. Alright, another frozen food thing. Yes, okay.
I dropped the ravioli, Mom.
That's okay, you didn't like it.
Okay. Can I clean it, Mom?
I don't know. I don't have time to figure this out. Okay. What? The dog might eat it later.
So see, that's why now I have just like lists and plans, and I do every single recipe a new one because I just feel like at this point I need to explore with food and eat my feelings. That's all I have right now.
Look, I think the Craigslist gods put us together for some reason. I've got no plans, and every time I see you make one, it just makes me a little jealous, and, well, I've got my mom issues, and you've got your...
Mommy issues?
Mommy issues.
Yes, bond with each other.
I don't know if that's a hurricane wind or a Craigslist guy.
Maybe we can just share the wall, and here, have...
My that's it. Share each other's activities and interests.
Well, definitely Christmas stuff.
Well, one of my interests is going outside when it's windy.
You will survive. We can do it right now if you want.
I think your hair would look real good if it got wind blown.
I do that all the time when I go by a metro station. It makes me feel real good.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Yes. Going outside and walking in the wind.
Wait. Can we do it together?
judging me, even though it's in your head.
Well, I have really loud thoughts, okay?
I'm just, you know, worried about you because I just think that this obsession with just everything green in your salad is not good. It doesn't give you variety. It's just like,
I have every food group in here. I have spinach, I have guacamole, I have broccoli. I think there are snap peas somewhere.
I'm just concerned for you because I'm your mentor, so I'm your boss, but I kind of like want to think more about myself and so mentor. I just think that diversifying your diet is going to be really helpful for you and your productivity, you know.
I really appreciate your concern, but I just also want to be able to live my life in the work kitchen like everyone else. You don't comment on Sally's lunch or Jamie's lunch. Oh,
I do. Here. See over there? That's Sally's lunch. I left a knob. Because like the meat's not properly cooked, you know, she's gonna get sick after that. That's the note for Chris's lunch. It's been there for 2 days. He's actually like just like partitioning it and eating it like a fourth at a time because I'm not paying him enough. It's so sad, but at the same time, I'm also concerned for him. That's Shelly's lunch. She thinks that she's better than me. So I'm just saying, like, no, not the meal that you think it is. So I can keep going. I mean, there are like 20 of us in the office, and I single-handedly just care for every single meal that's in this fridge.
This is a strike! Yeah! I'm gonna eat my raw chicken salad. Wherever, and I want a raise. And until we get our demands, and she gets to eat greens without being judged, and don't forget Chris's partition lunch because you're not paying him enough, and that man's supporting 3 kids at home.
He's over there with his head down on his desk because he can't even stand up right now.
Honestly, Stacy, if you keep eating raw chicken in the first place, I don't think you're gonna even make it to see that race that you're demanding.
That's my choice! I like it a little squishy on the inside.
I see what's happening here. Quite honestly, I'm just like, Stacy, I think of you as a daughter, you know? Because I'm your boss, but I just like want to love you more than that to feel a better person. So you're like my daughter right now.
Well, I don't have mine anymore because you wouldn't let me go take care of her last year when she was sick.
I know. Honestly, I cannot talk to mom anymore.
Me either. What is she doing? I don't know.
That brunch was just like a clusterfuck. That's what it was.
It was. Ugh.
I mean, at this point, we disappointed her. Just, you know, because we didn't want to be housewives like her. And at this point, all my degrees and all my published books are not enough because every time I sign the first page with all this love for her, I dedicate it to you, and all she says is like, oh, so nice, but I cannot even understand what's in it, so whatever. She doesn't pay attention to what I do.
So I feel like we're not mad about brunch anymore.
No, brunch is no more to all my mommy issues.
I was prepared to talk about brunch.
I see what's happening here. You're taking her side.
No. I clearly have some things to work out. I was mad because the brunch was gross.
See, on top of that, she takes us to a cheap place.
You can get pancakes anywhere. It doesn't really matter how expensive they are. Look, whatever. Look. It's okay.
That's what I want you to know.
It's okay. And all I know how to deal with is brunch problems. So sorry.
I brought hot toddies. Thanks.
Oh, was that not really warm?
Fun start, but guess what? We're gonna keep the fun going with our second group, but I just wanted to let you know that